This video is by Straight Goods News, sgnews.com.
As you know, it's not the first time that we face the upper government. We have been legislated back in 2011. So as postal worker, we know exactly what it's like when the government sits down on the employer side of the bargaining table. We are already living with the rollbacks. In the new urban agreement that we signed under duress last year, we lost our sick leave. Our demands to solve ongoing health and safety problems were brushed aside, and other changes in working conditions were forced on us. But now the government wants to be at the negotiation table in person from day one to make sure that their agenda guides the demands and strategy of Canada Post. And we think it's absolutely unacceptable, and we will fight that with all the other remaining service, because Canada Post is, we fought to have the Crown Corporation in 81 because we wanted to negotiate directly with Canada Post and under the Canada Labour Code to see exactly what are the rules. Now, if the government is at the table, there will be no rule. And there's a difference, an example with Canada Post, because Canada Post have given back money to the government in the last 17 years. They put back in the pocket of the government more than $1 billion. So there's a difference about what's happening at Canada Post. It's a self-sufficient corporation, and now the government wants to put his nose on it. So we fought to have the Crown Corporation to really identify the person who negotiated it. Now they just want to do it. And it can be difference around this issue about the mandate, because Canada Post has to provide a five-year plan to the government every year and adjust it. So they have their say, but now they want to impose, and that's the big difference for us, because they can be at the table, not knowing exactly the subject to negotiate the issue, but at the same time say, if it's not our way, we'll impose.